that it makes up for it. So why don't we dive into some of the principles in this book? I think most of our listeners will be familiar with the concept of 80-20 and, you know, Pareto's law and principle and all that kind of stuff. But, and you do talk about that in the book, but you also talk about this concept of the espresso machine, which kind of takes 80-20 to a whole other level. And so I'd love to have you start off, Perry, by just explaining what is the espresso machine concept?
So the principle of the $2,700 espresso machine says that if you manage a Starbucks and 1,000 people a week come through and buy a $5 latte, 80-20 says because 80% of the money wants to come from 20% of the customers, that one of those people will spend $2,700 on an espresso machine. So you got $5,000 from the 1,000, and then you got $2,700 from the one. So that's $7,700. And it's really, really important to point out that you didn't need to get any new customers to sell the espresso machine. It's completely from your existing customers. So you can use 80-20 to extract a lot more money out of a finite number of people. And this is incredibly important because, you know, you deal with consultants. Most consultants are not getting thousands of sales leads, okay? Right. They're not, you know, they don't have 1,000 people a month filling out a box on their email, on their website saying, oh, you know, give me your ebook. They might, but usually a consultant's dealing with a universe of dozens or at most hundreds of people and probably, you know, 3 or 5 or 10 or 20 existing or past clients, right? And the espresso machine is about making 50% more, 2 times, maybe even 3 times more money from an existing client list, which then if you do any kind of paid advertising or marketing, it actually gives you more ability to go get more customers as well.
Right.
But this is true. It's almost like a law of physics. It's true of Starbucks. It's true at a grocery store. It's true of a consulting business.
Right. And what would you say for the potential application for a consultant? Is it really just expanding your thinking in terms of your typical price point? So let's say if your standard engagement was $15,000, is the exercise that you might encourage a consultant to go through, you know, what does a $50,000 or a $150,000 engagement look like? Or would you counsel them in some other way?
Well, so the principle says that 1/5 the people will spend 4 times the money. And 1/5 of those people will spend 16 times the money of the original group. And so it says that it's basically a law of physics that money is burning a hole in somebody's pocket and they are going to spend it somewhere. Okay, so let's take the espresso machine idea a step further. 1 out of 10 people who buys an espresso machine might go on a Mediterranean barista cruise, or, you know, they might, I don't know, they might spend $20,000 or $30,000 on some like lavish, ridiculous, you know, and if you go looking, you'll find some coffee experience that somebody is charging $30,000 for.
Yeah.
Right. So for a consultant, you know, it's very typical. A consultant has like a $10,000 a month retainer or something right. like that. Well, for every 5 people who would hire a consultant on a $10,000 a month retainer, there's one that would spend $40,000 a month, and they will, and they are, or they did. So you have to, well, what would they spend $40,000 on? Well, if you want to condense it down to the simplest idea, it's sell results, not procedures. They'll pay a lot more money to get closer to whatever result is.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Some clients will pay us $10,000 for a report because they need to know something, but the report is only one step of some huge initiative, right?
Definitely. When